It was not in the direction of his follow through. He ran right across and he was nowhere near the ball. So he came and stood right next to the crease and clearly blocked Sachin's path to the crease. And Sachin was understandably upset. Remember, we all need to take into account what happened in Brisbane in the last match between India and Sri Lanka. India had a genuine appeal of mankarding there from Ravi Chandran Ashwin, but it was umpire Paul Rifle who went up to Sehwag, asked him to withdraw the appeal. And knowing fully well what happened with the David Hussey incident in the morning, it would have been prudent for Simon Toflan and Billy Bowen to go to the Australian captain Shane Watson, asking to withdraw the appeal against Sachin, but that didn't happen. Clearly big questions on the spirit of cricket, and understandably Sachin rightfully there feeling that he's been let down by an umpiring blunder.
Well, certainly Sachin has a right to feel aggrieved given the way he was given out. And we'll now join by Rasesh Mandani, who's there ringside at the SCG. And Rasesh, Team India understanding, feeling very, very hard done.
His follow through went to go for the ball, so he had no.
The Indian team would have been terribly disappointed with the manner in which David Hussey dismissal went, and clearly they found support from the experts as well. But in case of Sachin Tendulkar, I just wonder if Tendulkar could put his ground. There's no doubt about the fact that the pictures clearly show that that the bowler seemed to be obstructing the batsman trying to make his sweep. If that was the case, if Tendulkar could well have left the decision to the on-field umpire. Clearly knowing that there have been instances in this game as well during the course of the series where umpires have gone to the third umpire, then eventually discussed and deliberated upon. Tendulkar seemed agitated, but he walked off the field agitated. If Tendulkar could have stood the ground, and he is the biggest cricket in world cricket, and in the circumstances in the match he's in, who knows which way the umpires would have eventually tried it.
But he does speak to the umpires while he's walking off, and the umpires make absolutely no attempt at stopping him. They just let him go.
A rule in batsman's wicket was intentional.
Well, yes, eventually the judgment called that the umpires would have had to wait. The only option that Sachin Tendulkar perhaps had was to force the umpires to their fingers, to stand their ground and ask them to make the decision. He did not do that. But there's no doubt about the fact that on-field umpires also had a chance to call Tendulkar back off the 30 yards while he was on his way back to the pavilion.